Hello students, welcome you to the course of cloud computing. We are in the unit 5 and this is the last topic for unit 5, cloud software environments. So far we have seen many case studies like Google App Engine and AWS, Amazon Web Services. Now every cloud service provider will have to include a cloud software environment. So this environment is what which is providing the resources in the right manner to the customer. So we will see in detail about the cloud software environments that are available in cloud computing. Basically there are three cloud software environments, namely Open Nebula, Eucalyptus and OpenStack. So Open Nebula, all three are actually open source softwares, and Open Nebula is a computing platform for managing heterogeneous distributed data center infrastructures. So all of them are actually providing infrastructures. There are slight differences in each of the software environments. So Open Nebula is providing for heterogeneous distributed data center infrastructures. And Eucalyptus again is implementing infrastructure as a service. It is including private or hybrid cloud computing environment. And OpenStack software actually controls large pools of compute, storage, networking resources, namely the infrastructure services. And one additional feature is it has an OpenStack API. So it can include heterogeneous cloud computing platforms, as well as it will enable the user to also do some development. You know very well OpenStack development. So it is enabling the user also to do some OpenStack development in this type. So we will see each of them in detail. Now coming to Open Nebula. We already saw it is an open source platform, and it is managing to build private, public and hybrid implementations of the infrastructure as a service. So it is having two primary uses: the data center virtualization solution. So it is actually virtualizing the data center and giving us, and cloud infrastructure solutions, whatever the user is requesting, any cloud infrastructure solution, software related, that also it is giving. The entire software environment is open source, but Open Nebula will require us to own the license of Apache. So the Apache server license alone we have to pay for and get it. So the toolkit will include almost all the features of our cloud computing. So it is having integration, management, scalability, security, accounting for your billing, and standardization, interoperability, portability. We have seen all these terms, and it is giving a interface to wide variety of other providers. So we told that it is heterogeneous. Heterogeneous means it is going to allow us to interface with other cloud service providers. So something like Amazon, EC2 query, and EC is the Elastic Cloud Compute feature in Amazon. And OGF is actually Open Grid Forum. This is also an open cloud computing interface. And it is able to incorporate with the many hypervisors like Xen, which is an open source hypervisor based on para virtualization. So all these terminologies you have studied. And KVM, kernel based virtual machine, and the VMware all of us are using, so we know very well it is a virtualization tool. And Open Nebula also can accommodate multiple hardware and software combinations in a data center, so it is able to provide the resources, both hardware as well as software. So coming to the architecture diagram, you can see that it has a local user and administrator interface, scheduler is needed, and you have the services, cloud services available. Because you are interacting with heterogeneous users, you should have a cloud user interface. And of course, virtualization, storage, network, cloud, all this is common to any cloud service provider. And virtual infrastructure manager is the person who is actually providing the interface. And local infrastructure is nothing but your storage. And we told that it is also having a feature of public cloud. So basically, private cloud is for internal operations. So if I'm connecting with OpenNebula or I'm using OpenNebula, I will be provided with a private cloud. And a public cloud, if I have to interact with heterogeneous other users. And if I want, I can combine both and create a hybrid cloud. So that is what is the architecture like. We'll see a little more in detail. So we know very well what is the purpose of private cloud, public cloud, hybrid. So later you can pause and go through. These are only definitions about the private cloud, public cloud and hybrid cloud. The diagram is actually showing us the implementation as far as OpenNebula is concerned. So the left hand side square in each of the diagrams is showing the OpenNebula core. And if it is a public cloud, we'll have a cloud interface with the remote cloud. So we are getting from outside, we have to connect many people. So we are having the cloud interface. Whereas in the hybrid cloud, we don't have the interface because the remote cloud is going to contain private, public, and we are just going to incorporate that into our OpenNebula environment. So the OpenNebula environment is centralized management because we are having one administration domain, and the placement is, it is there doing in a very optimized manner, meaning that there is dynamic resizing, partitioning of the infrastructure because it is a very important feature, auto scaling. So it is providing that, and it is supporting heterogeneous workloads as we already told. And the virtual infrastructure manager, see, more n number of hypervisors are there, so n number of VMs can be created. It is including all these features. It is doing scheduling, monitoring, cloning and context means creating virtual machines. And then networking, because we are going to access heterogeneous machines, so it is doing networking. And it provides a uniform view of the resource pool. And life cycle management, it is going to monitor all the VMs. And it integrates the image network and virtualization. So all the features it has to take care. So coming to the internal architecture, we already saw it is a little more in detail. So we have the core, we have a scheduler, and all the drivers are going to provide the features. Local infrastructure is there, external cloud is also there. And CLI is command line interface. And the GUI, you know, graphical user interface, and application program interface. So all these three are for the OpenNebula to interact with our user. And there are some common terminologies which we will be using in all these software environments. Host means it is the physical machine which is running, supported by the hypervisor. And cluster means pool of host. And template means it is the virtual machine. And image means it is the virtual machine's disk image, that is the storage. So these are some common terminologies which we'll be using across all of the cloud software environments. So coming to the deployment model, how it is getting deployed. See, basically there is a master node which is having drivers and images, and through the secure shell, SSH, secure shell, a network which is nothing but a communication protocol that enables two computers to communicate securely. So through that, it is creating virtual nodes. So every virtual node is called as a worker node. So this is what is actually deployed in the customer side. So we have the VM repository, storage, everything is there. The master node is using all that, and it is going to create the host enabled hypervisors which will be used by the customers. So we'll see each of these modules in detail. So the OpenNebula has this front end master node, as we saw in the previous slide. then hypervisor enabled host, which are called as worker nodes, and the data store, that is what was represented as repository, and then the physical network. So the front machine is actually the master node, and it executes all the OpenNebula services and is the actual machine where OpenNebula is installed. And it is taking care of all the services, management services, scheduling, queuing, submitting the job to other machines in the cluster, and so on. It will also include mechanisms like adding virtual machines, monitoring the status of virtual machines, hosting the repository, and then monitoring subsystems. So it is highly scalable, and every now and then the performance will also be checked. So the hypervisor enabled host or the worker nodes, they are actually providing the computing resources needed for the processing of all jobs submitted by the master node. So the master node will actually have the requirement as specified by the user, and based on the user requirement, it is going to create that many virtual machines. And for every virtual machine, there will be a hypervisor. So that is what is actually mentioned, and the hypervisor can be any of these types. And they will actually run the hypervisor virtual machines, and it will take care of all other features for keeping the virtualization intact. The physical networks are nothing but the interconnections shown in the diagram we already saw. There were some bus-like structures. So they are the interconnections of connecting the storage servers, virtual machines in the remote locations. So they are essential to connect all the worker nodes or the host. And it is required because every time we have to create an instance, and it has to manage and monitor all the files. So this physical network is also a very important component. Then finally, we have the OpenNebula storage. So this is nothing but the data store which holds the base images of the virtual machines. So the data store is actually a huge data store in the data center, and that is taken out through the service network, and all these worker nodes host that many hosts depending on how many ever virtual machines you want. It is being divided, and they give the storage image. So they pass on this data store, which is very huge, divide it into parts, and it gives to the virtual machines. So they are deployed to the virtual machines, and they are getting manipulated there. So this completes the discussion on OpenNebula. We'll stop here and continue with the other two types in the next lecture. Thank you.